Like, it takes time to get the hit of all the flavors.
The first step is heat some oil and infuse the oil with the whole spices that you have. So you toast the spices in the oil for some time. Curry leaves. These are star anise. These are cloves. This is cardamom pods. These are black mustard seeds. Black peppercorns. Cumin seeds. Cinnamon sticks. Bay leaves. Recently I found out the bay leaves which you get in India are completely different from the bay leaves over here. The bay leaves in India have two spines instead of a single spine.
So we start with the oil. So first step, just like in the previous one, we are going to add oil.
And we'll wait for it to come to temperature. We have heated the oil, now we are going to add one cinnamon stick. One whole star anise, a few cloves, and one bay leaf.
One. And more curry leaves.
You can never have enough curry leaves.
And I'm adding some whole cloves.
Yeah. Keep adding the curry leaves. They taste amazing.
And the first thing you'll add is mustard seeds. No, more. Like, I would say 2 tablespoons or 1 tablespoon.
Okay.
A little bit more. Now you add the cumin seed.
How much?
Enough.
Okay. How much cardamom do you want?
2 pods.
Wow, no, this.
Or just put them in.
Yeah, just put them in. Ah, there.
Yeah, there you go. And star anise. Yeah. So the cumin is getting brown now.
Right.
So you don't want them to overcook more than that. I would add the ginger, finely chopped.
Smell is so good. How do we cut the tomatoes?
The tomatoes you can cut in many different ways. The two ways we are using right now here is sliced, which is slightly sliced lengthwise. Or you can dice them. You can over here we have a small dice. If you want your dish to be saucy, then you want them to be a small dice. But if you want your dish to be slightly dry, then you want them big pieces. In this case, we just sliced.
All right, and the onions.
The same thing goes for the onions. The smaller they are, they will dissolve into the sauce and they'll create a base for the sauce. But if they're longer, like again over here, which is sliced, in this case, the dish will not contribute to the sauce as a whole. It will contribute to the dish.
Okay.
You'll be able to feel the onions. Okay, now the onion. Now I'm adding sliced onions. Like at this point, you can also add the salt so that the onions give out the water and they soften quicker. But yeah, you always need to make sure that you don't oversalt stuff.
Mm.
You can never take salt out.
The base itself is called tadka. You can call it
tadka. Tadka?
T-A-D-K-A.
Tadka. Okay.
And we are ready for the next step.
Let it cook.
And now it's...
So you started cooking here?
Oh yeah, I never cooked back in India.
Really?
Yeah. Once I came over here, then I started cooking and then I realized I'm actually sort of kind of okay
at cooking.
Uh-huh.
And
for how long have you been in Montreal?
It will be 5 years in one month and 4 days.
Okay, 5 years.
Yeah.
So you started cooking 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Wow. So you learned a lot of things.
Oh yeah. Among the things I watch on YouTube, mostly it's cooking shows.
And where did you learn all of this?
YouTube. I'm mostly talking to my mom, but mostly YouTube. Because I had courses and I had limited time to cook in.
Uh-huh.
So I had to formalize my cooking method. So this is the way I formalized it. So I know exactly which step comes when.
Uh-huh.
Do I know? Yeah, so now we can add the tomatoes.
Okay, tomatoes.
Yeah, for my wife here.
Yeah, so because once it is formalized, I know that after putting the onions in, there is some time to wait.
Uh-huh.
That's when I would cut the tomatoes.
Ah, okay.
And I could cook a dish within half an hour, right from start to finish.
Mm-hmm.
Eating another half an hour. 1 hour and I would be done. Like, it would be good food.
Uh-huh.
And then the dish would sit in the for a day.
No, the thing is, at the end, when you put everything together, you need to wait for it to cook. That's when I would do the dishes.
Yeah.
So by the time the dish is ready, the dishes would be also done.
Mm. So it's very optimal.
Yeah, it's like super optimal.
Okay, so this is ready. It's like a bit translucent.
Yeah.
So onions not translucent.
No.
They'll cook more as we're cooking the rest of the dish.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm adding sliced tomatoes. Yeah.
Do you let it?
I'm marinating my chicken with black pepper, lime, half a lime, minced garlic, and minced ginger.
Mmm.
Ah, smells so good. Yeah, so if you see, the consistency is way different from the other one when
we add.
So it's much drier. So now we are adding this powdered spices. This is a Kashmiri chili. This is not as spicy as most chilies, so it's mostly used to give color, but it also has a kick to it.
Tick is a North Indian language jargon and translates to perfect, stylish, cool.
This is garam masala. I'm just adding 1/4 teaspoon of this. So this particular garam masala I got from home. Where
is your home?
My home is in Goa. So this is specially from Goa. Half a teaspoon of turmeric. Right now I'm adding cumin, half a teaspoon. Then we add half a teaspoon of coriander. And I'm adding a quarter teaspoon of turmeric. Oh, we forgot one.
Yeah.
Forgot the black pepper.
Oh, yes.
1 teaspoon of ground black pepper.
I'm going to add 1 whole teaspoon of coriander powder. Half a teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder. Half a teaspoon of cumin powder. And half a teaspoon of turmeric powder. Oh yeah. The next step is to add our main ingredients. So we just prepared our base, and from here you can diversify your curry. In this case, we are making dal, so we are going to add the cooked lentils, cooked split peas, and we are also going to add some drumsticks.
This is a drumstick. It grows on a big, large tree, keeps hanging like this. We, as kids, we used to play with this as swords. Yeah, a drumstick.
Okay, so this is done.
Now we add the chicken.
I'm adding 4 chicken thighs.
And then we close the lid and let it cook.
So now I'm adding the cauliflower in. I'm adding the carrots in. Okay, now we need some water. I'm gonna top it off with the water. The cauliflower is almost done.
Yeah.
So before that done, I want to add the rest.
It's written shake well before use.
This dish also works very well with mushrooms.
Mm.
So now I'm adding salt right at the end and seeing whether it's proper.
What do you think about ketchup?
Too sweet. Oh yeah. Finally we add the spinach in. I think that's enough.
More curry leaves in the end. Why?
You can never have enough curry leaves. Yeah, I think the cauliflower is done. You can just add the green peas.
I could have never thought, guys.